best way to start your day. Cutting through the noise and bringing you the real stories behind the headlines.
Talk to someone about how you feel. Do not internalize it. Do not consume it. You deserve to be heard.
It's time to wake up with Milwaukee's favorite morning show.
It's not just we canceled it, it's over, it's a done deal. Shouldn't be that way. That program still should proceed no matter how acute it may go.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue in the heart of downtown Milwaukee.
Telly, where are all the watch parties? Where are the brothers going to be? I just want to see what she was going to do.
This is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth App. Here are your hosts, the effective communication coach Denise Thomas and two-time Emmy Award winner Telly Hughes.
Good morning. Good morning, Truth Nation. Happy Friday. We're going to make this a feel-good Friday show for you, Truth Nation, because you deserve it. You're listening to the best morning show on planet Earth, Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. Good morning, Telly.
Good morning, DT. It is Friday.
How you doing?
Friday,
man. We made it. We made it. Good morning, Benjamin.
It's amazing.
Well, might as well get on into it. Now, I'm just going to say this. When the good Lord calls me home, Telly, I don't care how y'all feel about me. I mean, it's just like, I don't care. And thank goodness that when you go on to glory, wherever you go, you're dead.
That's it.
You're dead. If you have not already heard, which I would be shocked if you have not, Orenthal James Simpson, also known as O.J. Simpson.
The juice.
He passed away yesterday after a battle with prostate cancer. Mm. And in all seriousness, black men that are listening, please. Telly, what's it called when you go get your prostate tested?
Like, is there a name? You get a colonoscopy. If you are 45 or over, it's time to get a colonoscopy. You got to get it. And that does for colon cancer. But you get your prostate checked and you could get all those exams. So that is so true, DT. We're just talking about OJ and all the things surrounding him. And that is an underlining thing that most people should take away from this is it should be a reminder to do what you need to do. As a man that's over 45 years old, you got to get your prostate, you got to get the colonoscopy, you got to be regular at your doctor.
Absolutely, because for him to pass away at 76, and I mean, you know, 76, that's not like old, old.
No.
You know what I'm saying? Like without, to your point, if maybe he were able to detect it a little bit earlier, he may have lived longer.
Mm-hmm.
And let's just, I always wondered what was going to be the reaction. Even when the OJ, you know, Simpson trial took place, which we all know was the trial of the century. It is still regarded as the trial of the century. I was always curious as to how people would react.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Telly, as someone who has been in the sports industry for a number of years from a professional reporting broadcasting standpoint, you have a lot of friends who are professional athletes, whether they're current or retired. What was your initial reaction to hearing or reading the news about OJ Simpson's passing yesterday?
It definitely seemed like it came out of the blue. I know it was reported that he was battling cancer and I mean, when it first got diagnosed, but you didn't hear anything else about it. So you're thinking like, okay, maybe he's doing chemo or maybe it's in remission or whatever the case may be. But my initial reaction was, wow. And then I instantly thought, man, I wonder how people are going to react. Will his death be as controversial as his life? And when the reaction started to come in from other people, I was like, yep, because you had some people that were, let's just say, wasn't as empathetic as they could have been when someone passes. And then you had others that took it from a human standpoint. This is someone's father, grandfather, you know, friend. I don't know if he have any or had any siblings, but I mean, this, you know, OJ was more than just, you know, an acquitted murderer to his family. So I just think that the people that still had such strong feelings against him, at what point do you let that go? I mean, the man passed away, and you still have people coming out saying, yeah, that's right, and he got what he deserved, and I don't mourn for OJ. I mourn for Nicole Brown Simpson, and I get it. But, I mean, the man dead. He ain't got a chance to come back and make it right.
Let's do this, because what you're saying is exactly what is going to well, it's a great segue into this audio. Now, y'all know I love me some Shannon Sharp. So Uncle Shay Shay on his Nightcap podcast with Chad Ochocinco, they talked about O.J. Simpson's passing, his legacy, as well as the criminal and civil trial, because he was acquitted during the civil trial. I mean, excuse me, the criminal trial, but he was found guilty during the civil trial. But let's hear Uncle Shay Shay's reaction, as well as Telly. I want to get your reaction. And Truth Nation, we want to hear from you. Our Truth Talking text line is 833-212-1017. In this audio, you're going to hear also a mention of a tweet that Caitlyn Jenner, formerly known as, what was Caitlyn when before Caitlyn transitioned from a man
Bruce
to a woman?
Bruce Jenner.
Thank you. Bruce Jenner, as we all know, at the time when Caitlyn Jenner was Bruce Jenner, was married to, man, I can't think of anybody's names today. Kris Jenner, thank you. Kris Jenner, mother of the Kardashians, and she and Nicole Brown Simpson were extremely close friends. Like, they would vacation together, Rob Kardashian, Kris Jenner, when she was married to Rob Kardashian, they would party, socialize, hang out. They were very close with OJ Simpson and Nicole Brown Simpson. So Caitlyn Jenner, former Bruce Jenner, who then married Kris Jenner, you're going to find out what his reaction was as we listen to the audio from Uncle Shay Shay's Nightcap podcast last night. Check this out.
Simpson, one of the greatest running backs of all time, had succumbed to prostate cancer. He was fighting a long battle of cancer. He was at the age of 76. O.J. Simpson, known for his football prowess on the days of use at USC and the Buffalo Bills. Later, he's more infamously known for going on trial for the murder of his ex-wife, Nicole Brown Simpson, and her friend, Ronald Goldman. He was acquitted of the criminal trial, but later convicted on civil charges. Caitlyn Jenner tweeted, let's take a look at the tweet. Do we have it up? We're going to have it up, Ash.
It's not just us, Telly, see?
Delay,
Uncle Shay Shay goes through
Jenner,
it, too.
tweeted, very tacky, very distasteful.
Yes.
Basically, what it said was, good riddance. No matter what you think of someone, Ocho, you don't celebrate someone's death.
You never do that. It's one thing about God. God don't play. You don't celebrate nobody's death. Even if you despise that person based on personal issues y'all might have gone through. Now, you have to remember. Now, OJ, murder, the case, he was acquitted, but obviously
acquitted.
Was tried in the
so
civil case.
So let's pause right there, Ben. Mm-hmm. Thank you
now,
so
also,
much. Now, here's my question to you, Telly. And Truth Nation, we want to hear your reactions as well. So as you heard, Caitlyn Jenner, and I'm looking at the tweet now. Caitlyn Jenner, former Bruce Jenner, she tweeted yesterday, which has become a very controversial post, by the way. Two words, Telly, good riddance. So my question to you, Telly, and Truth Nation, because, well, let me hear your reaction first. Do you think it's okay to celebrate someone's death or be happy about someone's death, whether it's social media, maybe a news interview. Do you think that what Caitlin did was appropriate?
I think it was very distasteful. I think that if that is your reaction, keep that to yourself. Why do you need to let the world know that you despise this person? Because the only thing I could think about is if this was flipped. If this was flipped and something happened to Caitlyn Jenner and OJ came out and tweeted and said, good riddance, didn't agree with your transition becoming, you know, a woman anyway. Do you know that? I mean, they basically would have ostracized, or I mean, OJ was pretty much already canceled, but it would have been such an uproar. So I just think that, you know, Chad and Shannon Sharpe, they hit it on the head. You don't celebrate someone's death, regardless of what they did or how you feel about that person.
So I'm going to kind of sort of disagree. However, I do agree with the platform that she used to express, you know, her feelings about O.J. Simpson's death. Now, as a human being, if someone who I believed murdered one of my dear friends, regardless of the verdict, because, I mean, come on now. Come on, Telly.
Hey.
And I say this a lot to people. You know, they'll be like, well, how do you know? I'll be like, I didn't see OJ did it, but I'm pretty sure he did. That's how, I mean, it's like, you know,
yeah.
I am 98.999% confident that if he didn't do it by himself, he definitely had someone with him, but he was definitely there.
He knew
when
about
it happened.
It. At the very least.
I do not agree at all or believe that he knew about it. I feel like he was there. And if he has some assistance, then, you know, they got away with it too. Because at the end of the day, the state of California and the jury, they had to acquit him because there was too much negligence from the prosecutor's side. You know, and then once, what was that police officer's name? He was an investigator. Was it Mark?
Mark Furman.
Man, once, you know, he had the N-word recorded coming out of his mouth and they had, you know, found out that he had been messing with the evidence and planning stuff. I mean, they lost that trial.
Not because they
proved beyond a reasonable doubt, but because they got too messy. And Johnny Cochran at the time, he wasn't no joke.
Yeah. I just recall some of the things like, man, I got bad knees. You know, how can I do this and this, that, the other? I'm like, so every killer is in perfect health? Like, there's nobody that is a killer that may have a bad ankle or.
I tell you what, Telly, I'm not the fastest runner at all. But you let a spider or some kind of bug come in this kitchen, you're going to see my vertical. You're going to be like, man, Denise got a vertical like no other. Jordan will have nothing on me. So, you know, so a lot of things that we don't have natural. Well, I shouldn't say naturally. A lot of things that we don't do on a day-to-day basis. If we are provoked, you'd be amazed. Like, it's a miracle. My knees just went straight. I was able to stab people 20 times in a row. But, but in all seriousness, I agree with the fact that you have the right as a human being to, you know, be like, you know, good riddance. That person, you know, took away my family member, my friend, my loved one. Peace out. Good riddance. Doing it on social media, especially as, you know, you're a celebrity and they're a celebrity. It was based on what I'm seeing on People magazine, people's reaction. Yeah, they said it was pretty disgusting.
Yeah, I just think that
overall,
if you're gonna do something like that, what's your motive? What's your goal? Is it to make yourself feel better? Is it to get more people or likes to agree with you and say, yeah, I'm with you? Like, what is the point, or what was the benefit of that tweet? Like, what was the benefit?
Nothing.
Exactly.
There was no benefit. So Truth Nation, is it okay to celebrate when someone dies that you just despise or that you detest, or maybe even use the word, I hate that person? During the break, or during the pre-show planning, I was sharing with you, I was trying to think of somebody, you know, from a celebrity standpoint that, you know, I did not have any respect or admiration for during their existence. But when they passed, I wasn't going on social media saying, you know, ding dong, the witch is dead, the witch is dead. I mean, I wasn't, you know, because here's the thing for me. At the end of the day, however I feel about that person, they still have a family. They may have children. They may have a spouse. They may have grandchildren, which OJ had both. He had his children and his grandchildren surrounding him as he was passing. They still here. You know what I'm saying? And that's just because I wouldn't want anybody, because at the end of the day, there's a lot of people that did not like OJ Simpson after the trial. A lot of people. Tons of people. Like you said, he was canceled. But that man still had children and he had grandchildren who I don't know personally, but I'm pretty sure if they were surrounding him during his death, the majority of them, if not all of them, loved him very deeply.
You would think.
Like, that's just, you know, it takes a lot for us to not like family members. I mean, I'm not saying that there ain't some family members that we could be like, yeah, I'm good on sitting with them at the dinner table. But at the end of the day, come on now. We've got Van. Good morning, Van. Thank you so much for calling. You are live with DT and Telly. What is your question or comment? Good morning, Van.
Going once. Going twice.
Okay.
No Van.
Well, Van, just call
All
us
right,
back.
Yeah, just call
That's
us back.
That's okay.
Yeah, yeah. We so getting some smoke on the YouTube message board. Art Mind says, not a colonoscopy. It's a different, I mean, it's a prostate check. The two are different. Yes, they are. Get both of them. How about that? How about that? Yes, thank you for correcting me. I knew there was a difference because I've had them both, but I'm just trying to make sure everyone, especially black men over the age of 45, get it.
Sidebar. I'm going to, as a communication coach, ask people that when people are communicating, look at the big picture, because, you know, like this week we've had people call in and be like, well, it's pronounced this way. We talking about a missing woman and you over here giving me grammar school, taking it personal. Okay. Yes, Telly. Thank you for saying that. Get both.
Get both.
You're right. Look, you were right. I was wrong. Sometimes you just got to tell somebody you were right. I was wrong.
Right.
Does that make
but
it
just,
better?
But yes, but just do both. Just do everything you need to do from a health check standpoint, especially when you reach the age of 45.
Yes.
That's,
thank you, Telly.
That's
you
my
did
PSA.
It. Bill on the Truth Talking text line says, sorry, but does, oh, no, a minute. Yeah, Bill, you're good. We got your text. You've got the right number, Bill. So whatever you want to say to us, we got you. Call in as well if you'd like to. Chauncey says, yes, absolutely inappropriate, very classless, and grossly insensitive. I completely agree. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we want to hear more from you about O.J. Simpson's passing. He was 76 years old. He passed on Monday, or excuse me, the 9th. Or no. Today's the 12th. So he passed on the 10th. The news was released yesterday on the 11th, but O.J. did pass on April 10th. You are listening to the best morning show on planet Earth. Stay tuned. We'll be back. More hot topics to come.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
This is Community Heartbeat, presented by Outreach Community Health Centers on 1017 The Truth.
There are individuals in our community who certainly need health services, a variety of health services. What if they do not have health insurance? How can you serve that population?
Our community health center allows patients to come to our clinic regardless of their ability to pay, and that's part of our federal funding. You can come to our clinic and be seen based on what we call a poverty level. So anyone 200% or below a poverty level can be seen in our clinic for anywhere from $20 to $40 for that visit. So in other words, if your visit is a $400 visit and you fall on our sliding scale where you pay $20 for your visit, you would not be responsible for the $400. You'd only be responsible for $20 for that visit. Also, our pharmacy prescriptions are very, very affordable as well. Where you would normally pay, let's say for an inhaler, $240 a month for an inhaler, at our facility that would cost you about $4 or $5.
It's very good to know you guys have a sliding scale that makes it very, very affordable.
Eagle Sports Range has an unbeatable offer on concealed carry license classes. For just $49, enroll in their three-hour class led by expert instructors prioritizing safety. Learn laws, techniques, and mindset for responsible carrying. Stick around for an optional hour of range time with instructors included in the package. Practice under professional guidance and gain confidence. Open 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. every day at 2525 East Layton Avenue in Cudahy. Secure your spot at eaglesportsrange.com. Eagle Sports Range, where safety meets skill.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Saving energy and money is easier than you think. Here are two simple things you can do to reduce your energy use and lower your energy bill. Use thermal curtains to reduce each room's energy loss by up to 25%, and make sure vents aren't blocked by furniture or rugs to improve airflow and comfort. Simple, smart savings. Get more energy saving tips at weenergies.com.
Don't touch that dial. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly will be right back on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Wake up, Mr. West.
Wake up. You know how I get.
Wake up.
All right.
Wake
up. Oh, that was Bone Thugs and
Harmony.
Yeah,
there's
so many wake up songs. If you're just tuning in, good morning. Happy Friday. We were talking about the passing of Orenthal James Simpson, more so known as OJ. And, you know, his legacy, it's so generational. Oh, we've got Van. Good morning, Van. Thank you for calling back. What is your question or comment? Because you are live with DT and Telly.
Oh yes. Would you ask? Is it okay to talk about people after they're dead? I'm like, well, I mean, if you was an a-hole all your life while you was alive, that dying don't really take it away from you. So, I mean, if you did something in this world to make people happy that you died, you kind of got to live. Well, I guess you can't live up to it because you did, but you got to kind of own that. So, somebody go say that about him when he died, Caitlin, or say that about her when she died. Didn't she kill somebody with a vehicle?
I know it was an accident. I'm not sure. Yeah, good point. I'm going to look that up. Yeah, because there was a big controversy with that. Yeah, let me
look that up. Somebody go say good riddance when she died, I'm pretty sure.
Mm.
And they ain't going to be wrong for it.
Damn.
I mean,
man, you ain't telling no lies.
I'm not sad they died.
Man, that's another way to look at it.
Let me ask you a question, Van. How did you feel? How did you react when you heard the news about O.J. Simpson's passing yesterday?
I mean, I didn't know Ron Goldman and Nicole Brown, so I still see the football hero. I mean, I know a lot of people see the murderer. And, I think of the trial, too. I was, 14, 15 when that stuff was going down. It was huge. So, I see that, too. But, I love football, so I see the Russian master. So
that's
you know,
so crazy,
man. I get it. Some people,
That's so crazy, Van, that you're saying that. That's so crazy because I was literally, before you called back, I was literally saying, if you heard me, Van and Telly, I was like, people's reaction to O.J. Simpson was very generational. And so I'm glad that you said that. And again, yes, Van, exactly. Thank you for your call. It was so generational because for me, and you know, I wasn't born when O.J. Simpson was on trial. I wasn't born yet. Look at Ben.
You said, yes, you
You know what's crazy? Nah, I'm not going to say that. You know what? During the break, Telly, I'll share it with you, and then you give me the green light if you think I should share it on air. The reason why O.J. Simpson's death, or excuse me, murder trial is so significant in my life. But to Van's point, I grew up, my dad loved O.J. Simpson. And I knew O.J. Simpson as a great football player. Then I got to know him as an actor. Because remember, he used to play in the Naked Gun movies?
He's Naked Gun. He was in Airplane. He was in a lot of funny movies.
And he was hilarious.
Yeah.
He was hilarious. And then I also remember O.J. from the Hertz car rental commercials.
Running through the airport.
Go, O.J., go. Yeah, run, O.J., go. Whatever the saying was. Because I remember when I started flying a lot for work, I used to say, and Telly, I know you've thought it too or said it too, but you know, I realize I can't say it out loud because the first time I said it out loud, a lot of people gave me that look. So like when your flight lands and you got a connection and you trying to miss your connection and you'd be like, man, I got to pull a OJ. I got to pull a OJ. Some people will think, is she on her way to murder somebody? And I'm like, no, I'm running through the airport to get to my connecting flight. But it's very generational.
Yes, it is.
In terms of how people perceive him.
And I just looked it up, and Van was absolutely right. It was February 2015 when Jenner was involved in a fatal multi-vehicle collision on the PCH, which is the Pacific Coast Highway in Malibu. So, that is something. What if what if someone, you know, come out and say, good riddance, you're a murderer? I mean, like, of course, again, you don't know, you're dead, but I mean, your family has to sit around and listen to this, and just imagine that your parent passed away, and then there are people on social media saying, "Whoo, good riddance, glad they gone."
Yeah.
You'll be like, man, that's my dad, man. Like, come on. Regardless of how you feel about him.
Even the White House press secretary during a press conference yesterday, she was asked about the White House reaction to O.J. Simpson's death. And, you know, my thing is this. The reporter who was asking, I felt, and this is just my opinion, I felt she was being messy. Because how many times have we had so many living legends pass and they're not asked about it, you know, during a White House press briefing or press conference. So White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre, who is a black woman, who is an openly gay woman, was asked yesterday during a White House press conference or press briefing, however you call it, you know, what was the White House reaction? And she simply said, you know, the family has asked us to respect the Simpsons' privacy while they are grieving and mourning his death. Rest in peace, OJ, and let's move on.
And I think that was appropriate, DT, because she didn't like elaborate on it. She didn't say, well, we want to do this, or the president will be reaching out to the Simpson family. It was, hey, she recognized that he was an icon, regardless of how you felt about him. And it's just paying their respects. Okay, hey, our thoughts are with the Simpson family. I think she said that. And basically, rest in peace, move on. So I think that was the appropriate thing. And you move on. But if you say no comment, then that's going to make people want to get a comment from you even more.
Exactly.
Or why you're not commenting. So I thought that was handled very appropriately.
And to be specific, because I want to make sure that I give or share the facts here. A reporter yesterday asked Madam, or no, she would be just press secretary. Okay, so press secretary Jean-Pierre, if President Biden had any reaction to O.J. Simpson's death, or if the two had ever crossed paths over the years. Now, why are you gonna ask? Like, why would you ask that question? Ain't nobody asked no question like that. Now, you made me mad. So this was her response. This is her quote. You see how I went from Denise to Denisha in like 2.5 seconds. See, and you know what's funny?
You just made me mad.
People have said, Denise, you know, when I was growing up, they should be like, oh, you would be a great press secretary. I actually interned for C-SPAN, and we did, you know, numerous trips. And nice. I was like, no, because I know how I am. I'd be like, good morning, everyone. Thank you so much. First question, and this is what the reporter asked the press secretary. So her response was, so I'll say this. Our thoughts are with his family during this difficult time, obviously with his family and loved ones. And I'll say this. I know that they have asked for some privacy, and so we're going to respect that. I'll just leave it there. Do you know people are talking about that her response was awkward? Well, like my grandfather said, George Schroeder, may he rest in peace. You ask a stupid question, you're going to get a stupid response. That was a dumb question. We got all this stuff going on in the world. We got three or four wars at the same time. We send him $500 trillion every time you wake up in the morning. You got people who can't even afford to buy a house. You got DEI. You talking about... Here's a presidential election coming up. And she's like, does President Biden have any reaction to O.J. Simpson's death? You being messy. And that's exactly what I would have said to her. Security, take away her passes right now and give her 2 months off.
The whole thing.
No garbage like
so,
that.
So, like, have they crossed paths? Like, yeah, as a matter of fact, Joe and O.J. were kicking it in Miami last week. Like, that is a...
And they got the nerve, people. People got the nerve to say that her response was awkward. Yeah, because the question was. Like, what?
There was nothing awkward about her.
See, I love to do talk radio because I can go from, you know, thank you for tuning in to the Thanasis podcast, and I can go be like, what? You stupid. Get out of my life. That's what I
want
to say.
What?
I couldn't be no press secretary. I'd have been like, look, and Telly, you could, if y'all please go to YouTube right now so you can see Telly and I live. You could watch and stream any Truth Nation show. But Telly, this would have been by going to YouTube and searching for 101.7 The Truth. Telly, this would have been my face. She'd have been like, I'm sorry, did you not hear the question? I'd have been like this. So out of everything that is going on in this country and in this world, you gonna ask me a dumb boop, and then all you would have heard was boop, boop, and then it would have been CNN breaking news: White House press secretary Denise Thomas has been released from her position.
Hey.
Her podcast will be starting next week.
It reminds me of that skit on Dave Chappelle where he was acting like he was the president, and somebody asked him about his side woman. He said, "Now, why are you gonna ask me that in front of all these people?" That would have been reaction. I'd be like, come on, man. This ain't, why would you ask me that right now?
Like, as if she, like, to your point, like, as if she was going to say, well, you know what? President Biden was just asking about OJ the other day.
They were,
you know,
kicking
they were
it.
Hanging out. Like, I, you know what? See, now you done got me started because I'm going to find out who that reporter was. And you know what was really terrible about its situation? You know what it was really made it so bad, Telly?
What's that?
She was a black woman.
Yeah, sure was.
The reporter was a black woman. Was a sister.
Sure was. Hey,
what I say yesterday?
That's what,
we got to do better, black people. We got to do better.
I think there is a statute of limitations on the phrase, there is no such thing as a dumb question. Yes, there is.
Yes, there is.
Yes, there is. Now, in elementary
to
school,
to all of our
school,
young listeners.
Yeah, yeah. That's cool, but there's a statute of limitations. Once you become a full-fledged adult and you are what they call a professional journalist, there are such things as dumb questions.
But see, this is when you know that reporter ain't got no friends.
Nah.
She ain't got no true friends.
Because,
Telly, you know doggone well, if you and I were talking, and I was like, yeah, you know, I'm going to the White House briefing today, and I'm going to ask the press secretary about President Biden's reaction to OJ's death. Telly, you know, because we've done it before. Telly, you'd be like, nah, that's deep. Yeah,
like,
that's not
yeah.
a good look. You probably, yeah, don't. And you've done that for me before. See, that's when you know you got true friends. Your friends that can tell you no. That's a true friend. Like, where do you think you're going with that on?
Yeah.
What do you think you're going to get when you ask that dumb question?
Yeah, what are you trying to accomplish? Like, what answer were you looking for?
Why are you dating a man who's 80 years old who wears pink polyester suits? Like, all these things that true friends will tell you that she obviously ain't got no true friends based on that question that she asked. I promise you, they probably took her pass away. All right, y'all. You're listening to the best morning show on planet Earth. The Truth Talking text line is 833-212-1017. We're going to keep it live and funny for y'all today because, I mean, at this point, some of these stories, all you can do is laugh. Man. Stay tuned. We'll be back.
More of Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 1017 The Truth. Here is Denise Thomas with her truth.
Truth Nation, there has been an ongoing debate in terms of what work ethic means. And primarily across generations, you hear phrases like this new generation doesn't know the meaning of work. They're entitled. And the younger generation saying things like the older people, they work way too hard and not smart enough. All perspectives have some extension of validity. I want to share with you something that I heard last weekend that really resonated with me as it relates to work ethic. And the quote was, a lot of people want to learn how to play the guitar, but they don't want to take the lessons. And so, Truth Nation, as we continue to have ongoing conversations about the meaning of work and work ethic, I want to ask each of us to consider what work means to us. And in terms of what we are looking to gain from whatever aspect of work that we deliver every day, is it equal to what we want to gain? In other words, are you putting in the work that's not just short game or 60 seconds or less, but the work that is going to create a long impact on whatever return on the investment looks like for you? Let's start having more conversations about the meaning of work, making sure that we're aligned on what that looks and feels like, and ultimately not giving up on doing the work, because goodness knows, we got a lot of work to do.
This has been Truth Takes on the new 1017 The Truth. Listen to The Truth Be Told with DT and Telly weekdays from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m.
When you're high, you feel different. Pretty obvious, right? You think different, talk different, but if you feel different, you drive different. So if you're high, just don't drive. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality.
The traffic and weather update on the award-winning 1017 The Truth is sponsored by the City of Milwaukee's Direct Connect MKE. Make connections and explore career opportunities by visiting directconnectmke.com. We've got a bit of a backup on eastbound 94 coming out of the Zoo interchange towards 68th Street. And westbound 894 also backed up from 27th to 68th through the construction zone there. Also a crash on the ramp from Fond du Lac Avenue to southbound 43 near the Marquette. Just watch out for that. Not seeing too many delays with it right now, but just something to keep in mind. And check out the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Today, decreasing clouds, windy with a high of 58. Tonight, mostly clear with a low of 40. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 1017 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on the award-winning 1017 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Kyle Wallace. The Milwaukee Bucks are back in action tonight. They look to make it three in a row as they travel to Oklahoma to take on the Oklahoma City Thunder. Tip-off is set for 7 p.m., and that game can be heard on our sister station, 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee. The Milwaukee Brewers are back on the diamond today after their game was rained out yesterday against the Cincinnati Reds. They travel to Baltimore to take on the Orioles. This is going to be a big matchup of future stars of baseball as the Milwaukee Brewers outfielder Jackson Churio will go up against the Baltimore Orioles young outfielder Jackson Holliday. I'm telling you, this is a game you do not want to miss, so make sure you tune into our sister station, 620 WTMJ, with first pitch set for 6:05. This SportsCenter update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly serving your hometown teams, member FDIC.
Don't touch that dial. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly will be right back on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, the One World Music Festival is coming to the Riverside Theater on Friday, April 26th. This music festival will feature some of the hottest local artists that you love, like Chicken P, 414 Big Frank, JP, Joe Pablo, and many more. The One World Music Festival will also honor Milwaukee's legendary rap artists like the great Cuckoo Cal, Baby Drew, Ray Nitty, Homer Blow, and many more. Make sure you get your tickets today to attend the One World Music Festival on Friday, April 26th at the Riverside Theater in downtown Milwaukee. Doors open at 6 o'clock. To get your tickets, visit PabstTheaterGroup.com and search One World Music Festival. That is PabstTheaterGroup.com and search One World Music Festival.
And April is Financial Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered on learning about how you can best manage your finances. All April, we will speak with representatives from Educators Credit Union to discuss financial strategies and tools. Don't let me do this no more, Taylor.
Yeah.
Listen to me, Dad.
You can stop.
Get me in trouble.
Yeah. We'll come back to that
one. It's Friday, y'all.
Yeah, listen, we'll come back to that one. I'll do that one.
Man.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you. Thank you so much, y'all, for tuning in. It's Friday, and it's obviously live radio. So we've been talking about the reactions to O.J. Simpson's death yesterday. Now, Van had called in earlier and brought up an excellent point that a lot of reactions are very generational. So for, you know, people like Shannon Sharp, you know, he started his Nightcap podcast yesterday and was saying, hey, look, man, this is a living legend, one of the best running backs. You know, he was acquitted during the criminal trial. He was found guilty during the civil trial. But for Shannon Sharp, the O.J. Simpson that I knew and experienced was from a football standpoint.
Mm-hmm.
And so I haven't spoke with my father yet about his death. I'm going to call him today because my dad, man, I'll be trying to get Papa T to call in, but he can't not say the S word, sugar, honey, iced tea. But for me, it was, you know, as a child, whoever your parents idolize, naturally,
yeah,
generally speaking, you do too.
Mm-hmm.
And so my experience with O.J. Simpson was one of the greatest running backs of all time as well. Plus, you know, once he started being in films like Naked Gun and Airplane that were very popular when I was growing up, he was just like an overall good guy. I mean, O.J. was like, and what's so ironic is before he became one of the most despised villains in America,
he's one of the most beloved.
He was one of the most loved. Absolutely. You couldn't say nothing bad about O.J. Simpson. I remember he used to be a sports reporter or analyst for NBC Sports. And that was back before you had ESPN. I mean, ESPN existed, but it wasn't as big as it is now. I mean, you had NBC Sports. He was a sports commentator, reporter. He was on the sideline. And I'm going to say this, ladies. O.J. was fine. That was a fine man. I'm sorry. That was a good look. If O.J. was... If I was young, and I mean, I was around back in his day, because you know his first wife was black.
Uh-huh.
Sure his first was. Wife and his first two children. No, he had three children. One died in a pool, which I think is what resulted in the dissolution of his first wife's marriage. The baby drowned in a pool at their house. But yeah, O.J. was fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
And for you millennials and the younger people, that if you need somebody to compare O.J. to, let's just say O.J. was Michael Strahan times 10 back in the day. Like, as far as popularity, as far as how big of a personality he was, and
I would say bigger. Yeah, times 10.
Yeah,
you're right.
Yeah, yeah. He was like Michael Strahan times 10. I mean, he was the next Jim Brown, because Jim Brown quit football, went into acting, and very few people knew that, I mean, traveled that road, and O.J. was the second one to do it. And a lot of people are like, ah, he's making a mistake and he's not this. But he was so loved by everyone.
Mm-hmm. Very much loved. And, you know, again, and I know on the YouTube message board, which is on fire, y'all are having some great dialogue, or I should say exchanges on the YouTube message boards, which you can stream and watch Telly and I live right now on the YouTube channel by going to YouTube and subscribing. Subscribe to 101.7 The Truth. Again, the message board is going crazy. One of the comments that was shared was from Babs, and Babs says, it all depends on what lens you look at it. I look at it through the lens as a mother of a daughter. He murdered someone's daughter and someone's son. So I look at it the same way as Jenner. Here's the thing. I completely feel people's different reactions. My only thing is, so every time someone dies that you don't like, and this question is for you too, Babs, every time somebody passes that you don't like for rightful reasons, I do not disagree with the reasons or your position as a mother, are you going to tweet and go to social media and say good riddance?
Yeah.
I'm asking, like, what value does that bring, knowing that even though, you know, and I'm not going to say despite, because murder is murder. There's no but or and or despite. He has a family that is living still. And so for me, you know, there's a lot of, like, for example, and I know this is a trigger for a lot of us, Jeffrey Dahmer. You know, it's still for a lot of us in Milwaukee. And, you know, when Netflix released that documentary, a lot of Milwaukeeans were like, it's still too soon, especially for the victims' family members that are still alive.
Nasty.
And so it's like, we are a society that has gone to social media as this outlet. And for me, anytime I make a post, especially if it's drawn from an emotional reaction, Telly, to your earlier point, I ask myself, what value is this going to bring? Especially as a, and I don't have, you know, as many followers as Caitlyn Jenner does, but what value is this going to bring? What does this say of me as a human being? You have every right to not like OJ. You have every right to be disgusted. Like I said, I'm 98.99% sure that he did it. The only reason why I'm not 100%, because I wasn't there. I didn't see it. But I'm not a gambler, but if I had to gamble on it, the bets would be, yes, OJ murdered Nicole Brown Simpson and Ron Goldman. But I'm not going to tweet on social media good riddance, because it does nothing.
The man is gone.
And whatever he did, he going to have to pay the price. Because like Farrakhan said when they asked him after the trial, he said, you can't mock God. They asked him, do you think OJ did it? He said, I don't know whether he did or not, but I know one thing for sure. You cannot mock God.
Yeah. He's going to have to answer. He doesn't have to answer to us.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The Most High and OJ are now, that's in their court. Mm-hmm. And that's a court that can't nobody put a glove on and say, it don't fit, you must have quit. that don't apply in that court.
No, and there's no jury
OJ
there
might
either.
There be like, Hold on, God. Is Johnny Cochran up here? Can we get him? No, it don't work like that, brother. I'm
no
the
redos.
Judge and the jury.
Exactly.
Come on, somebody. What you say? Ain't no redos.
Ain't no redos.
It's out of our hands now.
Yeah.
So.
But that is so interesting that you can't have enough self-control to keep that to yourself. I just don't know why you would even want to put that in the atmosphere. And I mean, because the facts are he still died. He died of prostate cancer, and he still has surviving family members that are going to have to deal with this. And it may not be a loss for you, but it's a loss to a lot of other people that he meant more to than he meant to you.
And Caitlyn Jenner, you can have a seat. because I don't believe in throwing stones from a glass house.
Mm-mm.
You ain't perfect. Just because you ain't necessarily been accused or formally tried for killing somebody. You know what? Anywho, we're going to take a break. We're going to come back and we're going to get into, y'all, our beloved Good Times has been insulted to the most insulting degree of insulting. Mm. We're going to get into it when we come back. Yes, y'all, our beloved Good Times.
Mm.
Wanna know what we talking about? Stay tuned. You'll hear more when we come back. You're listening to the best morning show on planet Earth, Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Truth Be Told with DT and Telly returns after this on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Thank you, Truth Nation. Your willingness to share your stories with our community has helped make the Tory Lowe Show a two-time first place Wisconsin Broadcasters Association Award winner.
Hey, I'm tapping in from the Milwaukee County Jail. Yeah, man, they treat us real, real bad up in here, man. I mean, they got us sleeping in feces and urine. They took the batteries from us, told us there wasn't no batteries in stock. I ain't never heard that in my life.
We do this all for you, Milwaukee. We are the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk. This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Justice is about receiving what we deserve. Quote Audre Lorde, who said, there is no such thing as a single issue struggle because we do not live single issue lives. And that said, any freedom, including reproductive freedom, is our human right to decide what is best for our own lives. Reproductive freedom is about having bodily autonomy, which is the same as being able to control what happens to our bodies, including the decision to continue or terminate a pregnancy, rest with the pregnant person at all times and in all circumstances. Because when rights don't apply to all individuals and at all times, they are not rights. They are not rights. And as Black people, our rights are conditional way too often, whether we're talking about during police encounters, quality housing, or, you know, some job opportunity.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Hey, Milwaukee, my name is Martina, and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit amfam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
All right, Truth Nation, April is Financial Literacy Month, and The Truth has you covered on learning about how you can best manage your finances. All April, we will speak with representatives from Educators Credit Union to discuss financial strategies and tools they offer their members to help enhance your financial management skills. Financial Literacy Month on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by Educators Credit Union, Achieving More Together.
And when we come back at the second hour, and again, happy Friday, Truth Nation. We love y'all. Thank y'all so much for tuning in. I'm seeing y'all on the YouTube. So again, you can stream and watch us live. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel simply by going to YouTube and searching for 101.7 The Truth. Also, we want to continue to hear your thoughts. We want to read your thoughts, but more importantly, hear them. 833-212-1017 is our Truth Talking text line. We come back, we're going to continue talking about your reactions to O.J. Simpson's death. Also, y'all, good times. Netflix done it again, done messed up something that didn't need to be messed with from my perspective. We're going to talk about that. Also, former President Donald Trump made a visit to a Chick-fil-A in Atlanta. I don't know if you've seen the video yet. I saw it. Tell you want to get your reactions, get Benjamin's reactions. And most importantly, don't think I forgot. You already know what time it is. It's Friday. Ain't nothing but truth-telling hints going on this Friday, today, right now, today in the second hour. We go test Telly's black card with truth-telling hits. Stay tuned. You're listening to the best morning show on planet Earth, Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. We'll be back.
Milwaukee, we are in the heart of the basketball season, and we have all the local hoops news you need to hear. Get your weekly smile on with our Nothing But The Truth Basketball Report, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics. On Nothing But The Truth, we'll keep you in the loop on all the local Milwaukee hoops news, from high school all the way to the pros. So don't miss your shot to join in on the hoops talk by tuning into the Truth Basketball Report on Nothing But The Truth, right here on the new award-winning 101.7 The Truth, brought to you by Bubon Orthodontics, the official smile of the Milwaukee Bucks. 101.7 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to five Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on the truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Dr. Ken Harris, and the time is now, Milwaukee. You know, perspective is essential. What I found is the news behind the news is more important. I want you to leave my show with a sense of knowing what was missing that adds depth to the conversation. Tune in Monday through Friday, 4 to 6 p.m. on the new 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, or 1017thetruth.com.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee, Black. Talk.
And look at how Black powerful people are covered in the media and portrayed. We're not talking about their innocence or guilt. We're talking about how it is handled. It is an attempt to continue to perpetuate the stereotype that Black powerful wealthy people can only be Black powerful wealthy people based on their criminal activities. And that is not consistent and with other races or genders.
You're so right when you look at a lot of the people that have risen to prominence. With Bishop T.D. Jakes, man of the cloth, after you reach a certain point and it's, he's this or he's doing that, and tied him to Diddy. And the thing is, that is the common theme. And this goes back to the 60s. It goes back to Dr. King and Malcolm X and being on the FBI most wanted list.
Tune in to all your favorite 101.7 The Truth shows all day, every day by downloading the Truth app.
Are you ready to start a meaningful career in healthcare? Are you looking for a job that fits your work-life balance? Become a certified direct care professional today and make life better for older adults or people with a disability. WISC Caregiver Careers makes it easy. With free online training plus earn a $500 bonus. See your name on Wisconsin's Certified Direct Care Registry. Sign up today at WISCCaregiverCDCP.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services.
At the YMCA, finding your why starts by making an impact together, touching lives for the better. It can be the gift of time or treasure, supporting a community through talent without measure. Here, compassion fuels commitment,
finding fulfillment through enrichment, serving and improving. What a way to live, and what a gift it is to give. Find your why and get involved today at ymca.org for a better us.
You are listening to the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations. 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station. It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Black Friday on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is powered by We Energies. Energy you can depend on.
It's our favorite black businesses. Assuming I'm rooting for everybody that's black. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Assuming I'm rooting for everybody that's black. Yo. Yo, yo. Look.
You better know it. We are rooting for everybody who's black. On Milwaukee's Black Talk radio station. This is the best morning show on planet Earth, Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. Now, before we get into the Netflix, want to read some of the other responses that we've received on the Truth Talking text line, which is 833-212-1017, regarding the O.J. Simpson passing. So Orenthal James Simpson, more known as O.J. Simpson, died on Wednesday, April 10th, and the news from his family of his passing was released yesterday. Reactions on the Truth Talking text line include Dion. Dion says, what's so sad about it is that we believe OJ committed these crimes because white people told us he did. I believe that he didn't do it. Was it none of us there? And I bet you if white America would have never thought he did, people would not have thought he did it. So regardless of what people, that one man didn't kill two people with a knife. So let me just say this, Dion, and I'm not going to be monolithic, which is what I believe your statement was, because you said in your statement that white people told black people that he did it, so we believed it. As a black person who's been black for almost 48 years, white people had nothing to do with my belief that he did it.
I watched the trial. How about that?
I was going to say, I watched the trial just like everybody, whether they white, Kermit the Frog, green, fluorescent yellow, whatever color you are. I watched it with my own eyes. Hey. And then I watched the several documentaries that included his voice on those 911 calls. Man, OJ did it. It's okay, Dion. Look, it's okay. He did it.
White people didn't tell me Rodney King got beat up by the LAPD.
Come on, Telly.
I saw that.
Yeah. Now, Dion, let me just say this, Dion, because I understand your perspective. I understand where you're coming from. But I also want you to consider, Dion, that black people, we have enough intelligence that we can make decisions on our own. I don't need... And I'm not trying to speak for all black people, but I'm just saying, as a black person who's been black for 48 years, I got eyes, I got ears, yeah. I got a nose. I watched the trial. I watched several, the ESPN 30 for 30. Did you see that? It was like a 6-part series. Dion, I don't know if you've watched that, but you need to watch that.
Yeah.
Look at my face. He did it. That brother killed him.
And regardless if he did it or not, that's always going to be the question that surrounds OJ's life, not anything else that he had ever done. And you could have your conspiracy theorist about there's no way that one knife can kill two people or whatever the case. I mean, yes, it can. The knife doesn't go dull after one. I mean,
I want to remind everyone, including our non-black listeners, during the verdict reading, and I remember, and Telly, I'd be curious to know where you were. So I was in my hometown, Evansville, Indiana. Now, OJ was arrested in 1994.
Mm-hmm.
The trial didn't end until 1995.
You sure didn't.
And I remember I was working at a bank in Evansville. And everybody had went to the lunchroom to hear the verdict. Now, at the time, the room that I was in, there weren't a lot of black people. It was like probably 98% white people, and then me and maybe a couple other black folks. This country was divided. White people generally, and this was, you could see it all over the news, white people in general, I'm not saying all white people, but the majority of white people were, when they read that verdict, not guilty, disgusted, pissed, upset. Black people, we were cheering. Now, let me be clear. I don't want to speak for all black people, but from the conversations that I've had, this was the first time that a high-profile case with a black man as a defendant. Now, we didn't heard tapes of where investigators and police officers who were sworn in to operate with integrity using the N-word, planting false evidence, messing with evidence. And we were like, here we go again.
Mm-hmm.
So when the verdict was read, you had a lot of black people cheering, celebrating. It wasn't, oh, yes, Nicole Brown Simpson and Ron Goldman are dead. Yay! It wasn't about that.
Mm-hmm.
It was about, we felt as if there was some type of, finally, some type of justice.
Exactly. It finally felt like there was one justice system as opposed to the two that we currently operate under. I was in college. I was in my dorm room. And it's so, I do remember it very well, because when the verdict was read, black people were cheering, white people were like, oh, you could just hear like a collective gasp of oh my gosh, I can't believe that he got off. And the first thing I thought to myself, DT, I'm not gonna lie, maybe I've been this way for a very long time, but I was thinking to myself, why are y'all cheering? Y'all ain't about to get no OJ check in the mail. Like, so, I mean, there's still two people that are dead.
Facts.
Why are we cheering? I mean, I get that, again, we felt like finally a black person got off, because before then, if you were innocent or guilty, you were just guilty. You were just, you never got off. So that was, that, like you said, it was the first high-profile person, athlete, to be on murder trial, but it was also the first black person, and he'll go down in history for this, as getting off as a black man for murder, especially murdering two white people.
Now, I will say this, and you know, I've shared with you, Telly, and I share with Truth Nation on the air, I don't do gore, bloody violence, I don't do that. When I saw the pictures of Nicole Brown Simpson's body and Ron Goldman's body on the scene of the crime at her home, and I thought about their children, her and OJ Simpson's children, my heart ached for Nicole Brown Simpson's family, as well as, I mean, because here's the thing, there were so many different conspiracy theories, there were so many theories on, you know, and there's videos and audio of Nicole Brown Simpson and their tumultuous relationship. Nobody is new to, you know, being, we've either known somebody or we may have even been in abusive relationships, or, you know, relationships that go on and off. And there was a lot of drug usage in that family on both the Simpson side as well as, I'm sorry, Nicole Brown's family. A lot of cocaine drug use, a lot of, you know, stay with OJ, he's paying for everything. Then on OJ's side, he was very, you know, violent, all that stuff. So It was very toxic to begin with, and it ended very tragically.
Yeah.
Do I believe that he did it? Yes. However, I'm not 100% sure, because I wasn't there. That's how I feel. The man is no longer here. I'm going to respect his family's wishes, as well as know that there's going to be a time where, you know, I'm not on this earth. And I would hope that, you know, my kids, if they're, you know, if they're still here when I'm gone, that nobody is talking about good riddance, DT. Yeah. I'm going to tell you right now, Darren and Dominique, they're going to. All right, we got Al. Good morning, Al. You were live with DT and Telly. What is your question or comment?
Well, my comment is, if the glove don't fit, it must have quit. And I ain't never known a hand to grow like two sizes bigger. But when it comes to the Catholic Jenner person, boo-ha, be gone. You have bad body work and you're just mad because she didn't get the BBC. But I want to say this to the people who, you know, say good riddance to O.J. Simpson. I'm going to say this from my heart. Y'all follow God every day, and he bragged about genocide on the innocent. That was 2.5 million. And you follow that sapsucker every Sunday. So even if O.J. did kill two people is not worse than 2.5 million. And y'all praise to him every day. So think about that when you say good riddance, because he still got a family too. And if you look at your history, blacks was done even worse. And y'all still follow that so-called God who watch, who's supposed to have the almighty power, the one who bragged to the devil. So who's the worst?
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Telly, go ahead.
I ain't got nothing to say.
All right. Moving on. Thank you all so much for your comments and reactions. Again, the Truth Talking text line is 833-212-1017. Dwayne says, good morning. Good right back to you. Good morning to you. Now, we're going to talk about good times. Now, there's just some shows you don't play with in the black community. Good times for me is one of them.
Yeah, that's one of them.
And, you know, I understand that Netflix is a pro or is a for-profit company, and they're in the business to make money.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, what I saw last night was disgusting. And I use that word in the literal sense of disgusting. Have you heard about the new animated series spinoff of the original Good Times?
I did not hear about it until today, and it hasn't received favorable reactions. I can go out on a limb and say that.
Well, Telly, you know, I'm a person where I don't judge until, you know, like, I'm not going to say, ooh, I don't eat that until I've tasted it and actually said, oh, that tastes bad. Yes, I don't like it. Or, you know, I actually like this food.
Mm-hmm.
So as Netflix does, you know, they have algorithms that based on previous shows that you've watched, they'll suggest when you log into your Netflix, hey, you know, suggested things to watch. So the Good Times animated series on Netflix, which premiered, I believe, sometime this week. So I hit play. Telly, within the first, and I gave it, and I mean, I hung in there as much as I could. I gave it a good 10 minutes, maybe 12.
Strong.
If portraying black people in the most stereotypical way,
oh,
in 2024.
On. Come on.
Okay.
Are you for
real?
I
tell you what. Let's check this out. So Bernadette Peters, who we all know, played Thelma on the original Good. I know. Every time I bring up the end of the about 10 seconds. So let me go ahead and let you collect yourself. Go ahead. Look at all the male listeners. Thelma
was woo. All right, go ahead.
I think every brother from our generation has said that that was their first like crush. Like Thelma did it for
Thelma and Willona.
Same thing, Telly.
Ooh, Willona. Willona was fast. He was Willona's about them streets though. But all right, I digress.
As much as I talk about brothers, I'm gonna let you have this because I get it. Because I'm trying to think about if there were. There's nobody on Good Times where I was like, woo, Michael, woo, JJ. I got nothing.
What about Sweet Daddy?
You know what?
Sweet Daddy was something else, though.
Now, I done dated some pimps back in my day, but not even Sweet Daddy.
Sweet Daddy didn't even get you going.
I ain't hating on the pimps. Shoot. I had bills at a time where I couldn't pay. Anyway, so Netflix has come out with a animated series version of Good Times. Bernadette Peters, who played Thelma on the original Good Times, she was offered to, you know, do a voiceover just to kind of, you know, help get the show hype. Well, she was on TMZ yesterday, and this was her reaction. And we're going to hear her reaction and then tell you, we're going to get into this. For those who have already watched some of this ridiculousness called the Good Times animated series, please let us know how you feel. 833-212-1017. Some of us may like it. Let us know. But let's first hear from our beloved Thelma, a.k.a. also in real life, Bernadette Peters. And by the way, she's still beautiful. Man, shout out to her, whatever she's drinking and eating. Here's her reaction from TMZ yesterday about the Netflix animated series Good Times.
It kind of brings you back into the projects. So you have positive images generations before that. And then all of a sudden you see this. I'm not knocking it because I don't know what the whole show is going to be. Maybe they'll bring it more back, you know, back to a more positive situation. But when you have the name Good Times, our audience for 40 or 50 years have been really in our corner. They were disappointed that they didn't have it more progressive as the way I was told it would be.
During the interview, Stannis revealed that back in 2020, it was actually Jimmy Walker who played J.J. Evans in the original that pitched a Good Times.
And to this day, you can watch Good Times. It is still syndicated. It's on several networks. You can stream it. I love Good Times. And I love what Bernadette Peters said is that, what was the lady that played the mama?
Florida Evans, but her real name, I can't remember her real name.
It starts with an E. I want to put some respect on her name. But while I'm finding her name, she was one of the greatest thespians, a.k.a. actresses, in the history of the performing arts. She played many, many roles in both the box office as well as other television series, including Good Times. And I know for a fact that she was very vocal that even though the setting of the show took place in what was the Cabrini Green housing projects in Chicago, Illinois.
Esther Rowe was her name.
Made sure, Esther Rowe, that the director of the show, and I forget his name too, she was very clear about, we may be living in the housing projects of Chicago, Illinois, but you're going to portray this family in a way that shows us as a union, as a family who cares about each other. I love how they portrayed Michael as this young genius. And, you know, Thelma, she was always just so beautiful. And, you know, you didn't see her wearing all these ridiculous outfits and clothes. I mean, they all, you know, and it was very real. It was very relatable, but it wasn't like what you're going to see. And my thing is, it's 2024 and we episode. And if you're probably going to be like me, you're not going to get past the 10th minute. Yeah. It is garbage. And so what this new animated series has done is basically totally defied and countered the progressions of Black Americans. It takes place in a housing project. I don't know if it's Chicago or not. The father, he's no James Evans. I'm going to tell you that right now. He does not act or speak or discipline or hold his house down. It's just, it's embarrassing. It really is. It's disgusting. It's embarrassing. I'm not encouraging anyone to entertain this series. And I hope, and what I'm hearing is that people are already contacting Netflix, whether it's through social media tweets, or excuse me, social media posts, or writing actual letters or calling Netflix to take this down. And when you hear someone like Bernadette Peters, who played Thelma, say, this is not what I thought it was going to be, that right there should let you know it's garbage. Mm-hmm. She's not even endorsing the show. It is perpetuating stereotypes to the 10th power telly. And so I was just so disappointed about this.
Without even seeing it right now, I could just tell that it is so amazing to me when you have the resources to make it right, but you choose to not even engage them until after the fact. You heard what she said. She said, they came to me. And I'm hoping that they would do this. Like, you're supposed to be a part of the whole process. Why are you coming to me and telling, and I'm trying to portray, that's like somebody just saying, okay, we're going to do a movie on Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. And then they put it together, and then they come to us and be like, so is this how the show goes between you two? And we're like, no. And why didn't you just come to us while you were constructing this to get an accurate depiction, and we can both collaborate and figure out what are we trying to accomplish here with this reboot? So I just think it's foul that they don't even include the people that were in it.
Telly, they got scenes, and again, this is a current time, so it takes place in 2024. They got scenes where they show black teachers in classrooms with black students smoking weed.
Oh my God.
I'm not making this up.
What?
Not making this up. Then they have scenes where they've got like one of the younger siblings, which I guess is supposed to be Michael, but this is no Michael. Because remember, Michael was a genius. He was a certified advanced placement student. And in the Netflix I can't even get it out because I'm so disgusted by this cartoon series. The younger sibling sitting in the backseat of the car, and next to him is this woman with, you know, just all cleavage. And this is animated. It is pure garbage to me.
Is JJ at least is he still an artist? Is he still a painter at least?
And here's the thing. No, to answer your question, no. He is not the JJ artist that was portrayed in the original series. Now, I'm going to just say something to you, Telly.
Okay.
You will be surprised to see the celebrities, the black celebrities that allow themselves to be the voiceovers in this garbage animated series.
Ooh.
And some celebrities that I have grown to respect. It's about seven of them that are doing the voiceovers. Mm-hmm. One of them is JB Smooth.
You know what that's called?
One of them is...
I need some of that money I was missing out on COVID.
You know what that's called?
Selling out.
Whoop, when we come back, Truth Telling Hits is on its way. Y'all get ready. We need your help.
We do.
Because Telly has got to keep his black card. So coming up, Truth Telling Hits with Telly. You are listening to the best morning show on planet Earth. Truth Be Told with DT and Telly. It's Friday, y'all. Let's get it.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, it's your boy Benjamin.
And your girl Noni Juice.
Y'all know what time it is.
It's time to get jamming with Juice.
The hottest brand new show in town, Jamming with Juice.
Real conversations, juicy interviews, and a whole lot of fun.
From trending topics to what's happening on the streets, we got you.
Sip on Jamming with Juice every Thursday at 6 p.m. where we're always keeping it juicy.
It's amazing. Catch Jamming with Juice exclusively on YouTube.
This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Social injustices have created a long-standing list of disparities in education access and the quality of education. Injustice is also seen in sexuality education provided to students. Students really need the full spectrum of what it means to have the information so that they can take care of themselves. Reproductive justice leaders advocate for schools to provide comprehensive sexuality education, which helps students to prevent unintended pregnancies and obviously increase their chances of graduating. It's really important for the listeners to remember that even if you don't have students in MPS, even if you're not a parent, those students are part of our community and they deserve our support. The more that they receive, the better off they are, the better off our community is.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the News. 101.7 The Truth.
We Energies want you to keep this important safety message in mind. Before you start digging, planting, or landscaping on your property, call 811 to have underground utilities marked. Calling 811 at least 3 business days before you plan to dig will help you know what's below and can prevent a hazardous situation. Our representatives will mark the underground utilities on your property for free. So remember, stay safe and call before you dig.
We Energies, people you can trust, energy you can depend on.
Hey, Milwaukee, my name is Martina, and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
This is 101.7 The Truth's Sherwin Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. This show has meant so much to me because it's an opportunity for me to express my thoughts and my feelings to my community and for my community to express those same thoughts and feelings right back to me. Milwaukee means a lot to me. I was born here, raised here, educated here, and I'm committed to making this a better city. Join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the new 101.7 The Truth. Milwaukee, Black, Talk.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
I need a white horse, suicide doors, and we out of here. My horse kicking up noise when it's out of here. My boys bringing them toys and they down.
You are listening to the best morning show on planet Earth. Happy Friday, Truth Nation. Hope y'all are getting ready for a great, great weekend. You already know what time it is, Telly.
It's that time, Truth Nation. Y'all got to help me out. Hit us up, 833-212-1017. I solicit all accurate help. I don't want all help if it ain't right. So help me out with these songs, Truth Nation.
Why do I feel, Telly, it's been a while since we've done this? But we did it last Friday, right?
Yeah, we had Tori Lowe in the building. T. Lowe was here,
that's
remember?
Right.
Yeah.
Maybe this has this week just gone by really slow for you? Because I feel like it's just been forever since Friday. The last Friday was here.
It's been a week. It's been a week.
Man.
Thank God it's Friday, right?
Thank God it's Friday. Well, you ready, brother? You
Let's
ready to do this?
It. Let's do it.
Come All right. On, so Truth this Nation. Week's theme, because if you did not already know, we announced, or Telly, I should say, announced on Monday that Mrs. Hughes received this year's Teacher of the Year Award, which is a very distinguished and profound recognition. Also this week, Telly got his third hole in one. He shot his third hole in one. That's huge.
It's been a big week, yeah.
So it's been a big week. So our theme of truth-telling hits with Telly Hughes is going to be songs that we play when we are winning. Songs that we play that when we are celebrating victories and championships. Are you ready, Telly?
I'm with it. I'm with it. I'm probably not going to get any of them right, but I'm with it.
Now, let me just refresh your memory. You need to name either the artist or the group that is performing the song and or the name of the song. You get both, you get a bonus. Are you clear? Now, again, it has to be. Now, some of these songs have more than one artist.
Oh,
you have
boy.
To name them all.
That's
going to
be okay. All right. All right.
I believe in you. Look, if you can get three holes
well, somebody
in one,
needs
you can
to.
Do this. All right, let's do this. Song number one.
Hey, this the East Side Johnny Big Redemption like. Know what I'm talking about? Hold up.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You got this.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh. Get out the way, get out the way, get out the way. Yeah. Yeah. Get out the way.
Man, you either with Come me on. Or against me. Oh, God.
They play this at the Bucks games. Like, every time we win at the Bucks games, they play this song as you're leaving Pfizer Forum. Come on.
It's someone that ain't. God, what is it? It was something rock. Come on. I got your back. Come on. Well, you get my back there. Is somebody rock? Is it?
It's J-Rock.
J-Rock.
Can you give us the title of the song?
Win.
There you go.
Yes,
you at least got
yes,
the title.
Yeah, so what I get, 0.5?
Look, I tell you what, you ain't got a lot of help on the True Talking text line. Look, Dwayne, he's
and
like, I got your
got
back,
half
Mr.
Of
T.
Rock.
Look, Dwayne is like, I got your back, Mr. T. Yeah, way back.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Come on, Dwayne.
You got your back way back. All right, y'all. Song number two.
Kristen and Kristen Dior, they don't make them like this anymore. I ask, cause I'm not sure. Do anybody make real anymore? Bow in the presence of greatness. Cause right now,
well, I definitely know the artist.
And your answer is?
What can kill me only make me strong. It's Kanye West.
No, put some respect on his name. He is not Kanye West anymore.
Oh,
get it right.
I ain't doing that. I ain't doing that.
It is his name. He changed his name legally. The state of California approved his legal name change.
I'm not saying put some respect. What does mama name him? All right.
His mama named him Cassius Clay. I'm going to call him Cassius. You know what? You're right.
What does mama name him? I mean, I ain't about to do that. How many times did he change his name?
Not legally. Kanye changed his name to Ye legally. The state of California has.
He'll change it back.
No, he won't. And look, check this out. I can't give it to you because even if you go to Wikipedia, it says, yay, born Kanye Omari West. But that's okay.
Yeah.
You don't put no respect
but
on
if
it.
But if you Google Kanye West songs, I'm sure this will come up.
It comes up, yay. Are you really telling me out of all the people in your life? We talking about yay? You telling me? I've been rocking with him since pink polos and Louis Vuitton backpacks. You telling me?
His mama named him Kanye. Here we go with Kanye.
Yay, I have nothing to do with this, okay? If you're listening, I have nothing to do with this. But yes, we'll give it to you. And the name of the song is?
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Man. Mm-hmm. Come on. Wait a minute. Give me one
second. Where Dwayne at?
Man. How you going to say you got my back and then go ghost on me?
I mean. You've exhausted your
time.
Yeah,
I have. Yeah, go ahead. What was it?
Here we go, y'all. It's stronger. That don't kill me.
Yeah.
Can only make me stronger. I need you.
I knew the lyrics. I just didn't know the name of the song.
The next time Ye comes to Milwaukee, which has been a long time, he has been here since Summerfest, I believe, 2000. That had been what? 11, 12? Who? I'm going to take you with me. I'm going to take you and Mrs. Hughes with me. And then that way you won't forget.
Where they going to let him perform? Nobody want to let him perform anywhere.
You're being messy. You're being messy.
I'm being messy.
That's a trigger for me, and you know it is. All right, y'all. Song number three.
Like Jim, sit down. Indian styles, you recite these hymns. See, lyrically, I'm Mario Andretti on the Momo. Ludicrously speedy or infectious with the slow-mo. Heard me in the 80s, JV's on the promo. Am I never in the quest to get the paper?
This sounds like a song Sir Chance knows. Sir Chance, text in. I know it.
Ain't nobody has your back today, Taylor.
No,
I'm sorry.
Man, what is
nobody.
Up? I know it's Friday.
Nobody.
I know it's a, you know, y'all direct deposits and hit. And I mean, but come on now, help me out. It ain't too many stores open at 8:33. Come on.
I know one store that's open in Wisconsin.
Look at you. And right, you just call me messy. The nerd.
It's Friday. It's Friday. Look, somebody on the YouTube message board, they got your back.
All right. Well, I'm not even looking at that. I know it's A Tribe Called Quest and award tour.
Bam, bam, bam,
yes.
Bam.
I had to bring it all together, too, because you're doing this, congratulating, you know, Mrs. Hughes and myself. And, yeah, so award tour. By a Tribe
Called
Quest.
There you go. Yes. All right. Next. Song number four.
Smile at me, don't worry, man. Follow. Throwing money on her like she won a lotto. So she must be serious.
Hold up.
Scared of heights, come face your fears.
Fortunately for you, DT, I was just listening to this on the course yesterday. Wiz Khalifa,
nice.
We Dem Boys.
Hey! Hey, you better redeem yourself. I know that's right. Let's go. Let's go.
Yeah, we them boys. Holo, holo, holo. Right.
You got it. Look, yeah. Hey, you got it. Let's You're redeeming it. Yourself.
Let's
You've
do
got
it.
Two more. We got two more songs, right, Ben?
Yes.
We got two more songs. Now, if you get all these right, you keep your black card.
All right.
I believe in you, Telly. I believe in you. You got this. You're a champion. Hole in one. Your wife is teacher of the year. Let's bring it home.
All
Song
right.
number five.
Oh. No,
we are the best shuffling crew. Oh, <my God>.
Ben, let it ride.
We're not here to start no trouble.
Start no we're trouble. We just headed to the Super Bowl.
Hey, I thought this was going to be like something
get.
From like Beach Street or something when I first heard it.
Dude, you should have saw how you got your chair. You literally jumped out your chair.
Like, what?
Oh, my God.
This song is way better. 95.
Hold on. Sweetness is speaking. Let that ride, Ben. Sweetness is speaking. Go and drop that verse, Sweetness.
I love to get the pass. I practice all day and dance all night.
Hey.
I got to get ready
hey.
For the Sunday fight. Now,
what?
I'm as smooth as a chocolate swirl.
Come on. Let's go.
So watch me, girl. There's
hey.
No one here that doesn't like me. My
so,
Super Bowl show.
I'm gonna go ahead.
I know that's yeah, right, Walter. Go on, Walter Payton. May he rest in heaven. The Sweetness.
But the,
okay, I'm sorry.
But the only thing that's wrong with that song, DT, do you realize that'll be 40 years old next year. So
if you're, that's not part of this game. You're either
okay.
going to name the artist.
So,
ain't nobody ask you, Ben.
So,
about,
it was called the Super Bowl Shuffle by the 1985 Chicago Bears. I want to say it was Steve McMichael was on that song. Gosh, the lineman, Dan. Yeah. Yeah, but Refrigerator Perry, you know, Walter
minute,
Payton, all those guys, yeah.
I would pay any amount of money right now to see all the listeners, Truth Nation, Kyle, everybody's face, because some people had just turned in, and they was like, wait a minute, what station
is this? Right.
Y'all should never gave me a mic. Won't he do it? You should have never gave me a mic.
Hey, yesterday it was about the truth, and we talk about all this black stuff, and it's like Martin when they turn it to a country station. You listen to the WEA, yeehaw! They'd be like, wait a minute. I thought this was the truth.
No. You know, people was like, what station is this? But then they was like, oh, yeah, DT, she co-hosts. So, yeah, that's some stupid stuff that she put. I take the Packers smoke all year long. The Bears still suck. The Bears still suck. I had to leverage my power. All right, here we go. We're bringing it home. Last song, Truth Telling Hits, song number six.
House to a bigger house. Ain't have a girlfriend, but the is out. Chanel croc back, ain't even out. With the gold chains, Himalayan broken. Lit it up, popped it. I hit him up, I'm talking color money. Purple yin and blue germ. I got brown lira. I ain't talking about Ross.
Hey. That's what I'm talking about. That's where we going. Truth be told,
yeah,
we going all the way up.
You got to name every artist that was on this song.
I can
only
give
three.
You two.
You can give me three. Just think about it. Take your time. I'll give you a hint.
Well, that's not much of a hint. I don't know if you're doing Master P or Rick Ross.
Ben, do the impression. That's what he does. He goes, eh. Okay.
I know I got Fat Joe and Remy Ma.
Yep. And come on, give it to me. The third one.
Okay, yeah, I got to give you something more than eh.
He been real quiet since the Diddy thing came out because he was real booed. I mean, he was real good friends with Diddy.
He got a big ass head.
He dated Khloe Kardashian.
He from Morocco.
I'm still. French Montana.
There you go.
French Montana.
There you
okay.
go.
Because, you know, all these clues y'all giving me, I'm like, I can think of so many other people that y'all talking about. Big
right?
head.
When I said Diddy, one of Diddy's booze, she right. was like,
Hey, no, when you said that, I was like, no, Stevie J been hanging out with him lately. What? I'm telling you, my mind was going a lot of places.
What'd you say? That wasn't a good $10,000 pyramid.
No.
Remember the show, $10,000 pyramid?
Oh, yeah.
Diddy's Lover. Oh, well, that's about 1,000 right. people.
Pass.
Makes noises when he raps.
Pass. Like every clue you gave me, pass.
Look, here comes Chauncey. Like, he's Chauncey remind me, remember the Lethal Weapon movies? Like, they need the police to come, and then when everybody is saved, then here come the police at the final. The credits are about to roll. Here comes Chauncey talking about my bad.
Yeah. Ooh. Come on. No, you know what? Yeah, you could explain what you got going on, but the bottom line was you wasn't here when Truth Telling Hits was going on.
Don't you love our people? Like, if your life depended on it, Telly, you'd be dead if you waited on Chauncey. Talk about, well, what had happened was.
But like, I know who not to call in case of an emergency.
And he's given all these details. I was watching the stock market, it's a critical day. Right. You got it, Chauncey. Don't mind right. us. It's your world.
Because what's more important, Truth Telling Hits or the stock market? Come on, man. Talking about I'm waiting for the opening bell.
Black people are struggling, Chauncey. You ever talk about, well, I was waiting for the stock market to open. It's a critical day. Shut up.
NASDAQ, Truth Telling Hits. Which one should I invest in today?
There's always one. We're not balling for the banana in the tailpipe. There's always one. Always. Well, Telly, I couldn't help you because I was too busy looking at the stock market. Really? Really, brother?
I was getting my portfolio together.
What? And then, you know, Bloomberg, I gotta look the update on Bloomberg. It's a big thing, Telly. Okay, couldn't help you out.
I'm
brother, all you
these
had to say
hot dogs
was,
on sale,
I
man.
Was
what are you talking about? We got bigger issues.
So what are President Biden's reactions to OJ's death? What?
What?
All right.
That was my reaction.
All right, y'all. We go into break. We come back. We still got more of the best morning show on planet Earth. Truth be told, Telly has his black heart, so we got to Ben jamming. We got to give him his theme music.
Yeah, let it ride to the break.
Oh, Lord.
Let it ride. Go ahead.
I'm going to put the mic down on that one.
Go ahead, Ben. Let it ride.
Get in the swamp.
Here I go.
Hey.
Here I go. Here I go.
Here I go.
Here I go.
Here I go.
Here I go.
Somebody say you was looking for me.
Don't touch that dial. Truth be told, with DT and Telly, we'll be right back on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. It's time for Truth Takes, a thought-provoking commentary on the new 1017 The Truth. Here is Melanie Ricks with her truth.
What's up, everybody? It's Melanie Ricks from Nothing But The Truth with Melanie Ricks. A thought that I have on my mind today, you have to put out the energy that you want to receive in return. I've noticed recently that I tend to have expectations for others that I don't also have for myself. For example, if I text my friend, I expect them to respond instantly. But if somebody texts me, oh, I'll take my time and respond whenever I'm good and ready to. So why is it that I feel as if others have to get back to me right away if I'm not willing to get back to them? That's just one minor example. But when it comes to work, let's say you're feeling dissatisfied with your job performance or maybe with the atmosphere, what's going on with work, perhaps so you're hoping for a promotion of some sort and things just aren't going the way that you want. Okay, so what are you doing to fix that? What are you doing to work your way towards a better work situation? What is the energy that you are putting toward your job, toward your coworkers, even when it comes to family dynamics and other relationships, or perhaps encounters with strangers? What is the energy that you are giving to the people around you? And what is the energy that you expect in return? I sincerely believe in the law of attraction, and I very much do feel that what you put out is what you will receive. So if you are someone who feels as if you are not getting the best out of things in life, perhaps it's because you are not putting your best foot forward and you are not putting the best energy that you can toward those things. The law of attraction is real, y'all. I'm telling you.
Listen to Nothing But the Truth with Melanie Ricks, weekdays from noon to 1 p.m.
After a serious accident, you'll need a winning team to protect your rights. Trust Wisconsin's own Gruber Law Offices, proud partner of your Milwaukee Brewers. One call, that's all.
Are you or anyone you know looking for a job? Direct Connect MKE is a social media style platform that empowers you to grow your social network, find career opportunities, and connect with career specialists for success. Visit joindcmke.com today to learn how you can create a profile, upload your resume, and find access to information about jobs, job training, hiring events, and more. DCMKE is locally focused and equips you to grow your social capital and find opportunities that match your career interests. Visit joindcmke.com today and connect your dream to reality.
The traffic and weather update on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is sponsored by the City of Milwaukee's Direct Connect MKE. Make connections and explore career opportunities by visiting directconnectmke.com. Northbound on 4394, heading over the high-rise bridge. We have the left lane blocked with a broken-down vehicle, so watch for delays through there. We've also got an accident on 94 southbound right about at Drexel off on the left shoulder. Delays on westbound 894, backing up from 27th Street all the way to 84th. Also, southbound 43, slowing from Hampton down past Capitol. Northbound's backed up from Fond du Lac Avenue up to about Keefe. And checking the TMJ4 storm team forecast today, decreasing clouds, windy with a high of 58. Tonight, mostly clear with a low of 40. For the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 101.7 The Truth.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Kyle Wallace. The Milwaukee Bucks are back in action tonight. They look to make it 3 in a row as they travel to Oklahoma to take on the Oklahoma City Thunder. Tip-off is set for 7 p.m., and that game can be heard on our sister station, 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee. The Milwaukee Brewers are back on the diamond today after their game was rained out yesterday against the Cincinnati Reds. They travel to Baltimore to take on the Orioles. This is going to be a big matchup of future stars of baseball as the Milwaukee Brewers outfielder Jackson Churio will go up against the Baltimore Orioles young outfielder Jackson Holliday. I'm telling you, this is a game you do not want to miss, so make sure you tune into our sister station, 620 WTMJ, with first pitch set for 6:05. This SportsCenter update is presented by Associated Bank, proudly serving your hometown teams, member FDIC.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, we've been talking about it for weeks, and it is that time. Join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th. That's tomorrow for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up to be a volunteer. Time is running out, and you can help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins gets a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today. No, register right now. This is going down tomorrow. And you can register right now at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com. And beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs. We just had a very interesting Truth Be Told. And
He's still texting.
Oh, man. So, Chauncey, like, this is one of those times you just kind of let it go because you literally said, I'm actually stalking Opening Bell right now. Now, you talking about the NASDAQ and all this and people around here waiting on salami to go on sale, and you talking about the stock market. Come on, Chauncey. Just say, brother, I couldn't get it. Black, I couldn't be there.
On a Black Talk Radio show. You need his help. He's like, well, I'm so sorry, Telly. My bad. I'm actually stocking opening bell tonight. It's a critical day with the stock market.
And then talking about Aura open up at $6.71, about 1,000 shares. I don't know what that means. Come on, Chauncey, man. We got to do better.
Dear black people, when your other friends that are black need your help, please do not say, oh, my bad. I was too busy watching the stock market. I'm waiting for the bell to ring.
And the bell rings pretty much the same time every day, by the way. But, hey, we ain't going to go there. But where we will go is the break, and we'll have Truth of the Matter coming up after this.
Can't make it up.
You are listening to Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
Beautify your entertainment space with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Hi, this is Gina Della from Pella. Turn your ordinary space into something extraordinary with brand new Pella Windows. The luxurious look, sleek design, and custom colors available is guaranteed to give your home the extra pop to entertain and keep you comfortable. At Pella, we see windows differently. We have the highest rated energy efficient products and a complete range of durable, functional, and high quality products that bring out the best of your home. Plus, getting the perfect windows and doors for your home has never been easier. Right now, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. That's right, get 0% interest for up to 36 months or no down payment, no interest, and no payments for up to 18 months if you book before April 30th. Take ownership of your living space and make it a place worth living with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin.
Hey Milwaukee, my name is Martina and I'm with the Independent Living Supports Pilot Program team. We help adults 55 plus and those 18 plus living with disabilities, providing up to $7,200 for home services, medical equipment, home modifications, and more. There's less than 30 days left to sign up for this program. See if you qualify today. Call 414-289-6874. Again, that's 414-289-6874. This program is made possible by Milwaukee County and Wisconsin Department of Health and Human Services.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Riverside Theater on April 26th will be the place to be. The One World Music Festival is coming to Milwaukee, and it will feature great local artists that you don't want to miss. Performances by Chicken P, 414 Big Frank, and many more. There will also be special tributes to honor artists of the past, like the great Cuckoo Cow, Baby Drew, and Ray Nitty. April 26th, get your tickets today by visiting patstheatergroup.com and search One World Music Festival.
It is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Yeah, y'all know what it is, Truth Nation. This is Truth Be Told with DT and Telly, your boy Ben Jammin, and this is Truth.
All right, Truth Nation, this has been a great week, and this could not have been a great week without each of you tuning in and listening. And for that, again, we thank you so much. My truth of the matter, as we enter the weekend, look, we all have dreams. We all have goals, but without ambition, you can't get any one of them. Each of you, including myself and Telly, we are unstoppable when we use ambition to drive us. Whether you want to be the next, what did he say? I'm in the stock market. Telly, is he ringing the bell? Whether you want to ring the bell on the New York Stock Exchange or want to be a professional scientist, whatever your goals and dreams are, do not listen to the outside. You are in control and use that ambition because it is undeniable, it's unbeatable, and it makes you unstoppable. Claim it, keep pushing. We got this, Truth Nation. Make it a great weekend and don't forget to get some rest.
Yes, yes. We talked a lot about that this week. It has been a really good week. My truth of the matter is we talked earlier in the show about the passing of O.J. Simpson and the tweet that Caitlyn Jenner put out there. And I just want to challenge everyone to really reassess before you hit the send button. What is this benefiting? And it doesn't matter if it's a tweet about someone who passed away or any other thing that may be disparaging, remarks or towards someone. Is this for the greater good? Is this tweet going to bring something positive out of it? And so if you have that mindset, then you won't have to go back and apologize for things because you've already thought it out. So there's nothing wrong with thinking out and reexamining and rereading things and proofreading things and asking yourself that question before you hit send, because what Caitlyn Jenner did was very insensitive, it was classless, and it only brought a negative light on her. So again, just be careful, because social media plays such a big part in our world and in our society. Only thing you got to do is just read it twice before you hit send. That's all.
All great words, Telly. Thank you so much. Up next, you've got 9 more hours of consecutive live Black Talk Radio. Up next, Sherwin Hughes. Make it a great weekend. We love you. We love you. We love you. Don't spend it all in one place. We'll see you next week.
Peace out.